Nursing homes are what we call high touch, not high tech. And so the quality of care is really dependent on the hands of the people who touch them. Many people have promised their parent that they'll never put them in a nursing home because they're so sterile, they're cold and institutional. People sit parked in front of an elevator with nothing to do, nothing to look at. That's something that frightens people. They don't want to be in a place like that. There really are people who are frail, who are needy. Taking care of them and being sure that they got the best possible care really became a passion for me. You are saving money by providing something better rather than giving people less. One of the things we've been working on for many years here at the Commonwealth Fund is trying to think about how do we reorient nursing homes away from the idea of an institutional model and really focus them back on the resident themselves. We've been a major supporter of a quality campaign for nursing homes called Advancing Excellence. Over 9,000 nursing homes have signed up for it. That's over 58% of all the nursing homes in the United States. We give them materials so that they can not only improve their performance, they can measure how well they've improved or how much they've improved. The whole point is to use quality improvement as a way to help the residents and to save money for the system without cutting back on services. This voluntary campaign really has been able to make a difference. When we look at the nursing homes that have been participants in the campaign, we're able to show that those that are in the campaign have improved as a group further and faster. Taking these materials, working with these tools, does make a difference. Sometimes when I'm asked to give talks to groups of people, I say to them, how many of you are looking forward to going in a nursing home? And usually no one raises their hand. What it would look like if I'm successful is everybody in that room raises their hand.